There's a lot of people making money and very happy in alternative radio, but that just ain't me, but I might end up there. Ain't no fun waiting around to be a millionaire. Going down the road, man, whatever happens, happens.
Hello, and welcome to tonight's edition of Reaching for the Stars. I'm your host, Joe Katz, and with us tonight is a very special guest. I'm very proud to have him on. I'm a personal fan of his. We have with us tonight Mr. Butch Willis, who is a local rock and roller, and to quote the Washington Post, Butch Willis has moved into the most selective rock and roll territories, that of the inspirational primitive. Guided by neither the commercial concerns of mainstream pop, the calculated artsiness of new wave, nor the hip rage of punk, Willis stands quite alone. Undaunted, he dreams the rock and roll dream, and I'm going to reach for this star right here, right now. Butch Willis, glad to have you here.
Thank you, Joe.
Now, you used to be a roommate of one Root Boy Slim, the notorious Root Boy Slim, and would you consider Root Boy Slim as one of your musical influences?
Well, something like World War III, I kind of came up with a thing called the TVs from Outer Space.
Ah, one of my favorites.
TVs from Outer Space.
Is the first thing I can remember hearing when I was a kid. I mean, like, that was the first music that I could remember hearing was Splish Splash, or that came out a little later. I mean, like, at 3 years old, I was rocking to Elvis.
The album is forthcoming, Butch's second album. How did this record come about? And the label is the Love Label.
The Love Label. That's my label. I can't afford it anymore. I spent $10,000 on two albums and got back about $1,500.
Well, Butch, we're going to have to wrap it up here because it looks like we're running out of time. But we sure appreciate you coming by and taking time out of your busy schedule. I know that you've got a lot on your mind these days, and what does the future hold for one Butch Willis?
I'm contract shopping right now, and there are a couple of people looking for me.
That's great stuff. We wish you the best of everything, and that's it,
Joe,
for tonight.
I had a good time.
Good night, folks. This is where we just talked a little bit, and we're
here is one of my old favorite albums. I used to love this album. I used to play this thing to death. Threshold of a Dream, Moody Blues. Probably their best album. But after a thousand times, it tends to get boring. Rubber Biscuit! Yeah, there they are. It's hard at the end, The Who. Can they all be back in another 40 years?